Starting in the colonial era, the great wealth of Charleston, South Carolina was built on rice grown and harvested by thousands of slaves torn from Africa. Countless acres of swampland were turned into rice fields with bare hands. An entire ecosystem was changed. Now the rice fields are gone, and the land is returning to its original roots, burying its tangled past in the process. Richard Porcher, noted botanist and author, recently came to Clemson University to tell the tale of the rice industry in South Carolina, from its beginnings in the 1670s to its demise in the early 20th century.
We're going to look how one crop shaped the low country of South Carolina and how natural history and cultural history met to form the landscape of South Carolina. If rice had not been introduced in the 1600s, when you cross the Sandy Delta, the Combahee River, the Ashapu, and see this mass of marsh, all that would still today be a swamp forest. The entire low country today, all those abandoned rice fields with marsh today, would still be some type of cypress swamp. 150,000 acres of tidal freshwater swamp were cleared and made into rice. An entire ecosystem was eliminated from the low country. We'll start our story with Charleston, America's most historic city. If rice had not been introduced, the city of Charleston as we know it today would not exist. Savannah, Georgetown, they were built with rice money. And do not ever forget the richness of the Lowcountry of South Carolina was built on the backs of enslaved Africans. The slaves lived out here in that banked off area. Some of them probably spent their entire life in that village, probably never got back to the highland. They didn't even know what the highland was. I'd sit up there one time and just try to reflect. What was the life of a slave family out in that delta? What did they think about? What aspiration did they have for the kids? Could they even have any aspirations after working the deadly rice fields every day? Where'd they bury the dead? Where'd the food come from? Nobody knows. History closed its pages on the slave villages in the Santee Delta. I went to Sierra Leone where that famous door of no return is, where the slaves would pass through that door and get on a ship to come over here. And if you never ever have a chance, every person, black or white, whoever you are, should try to go to Africa and stand in front of that door of no return. And I guarantee you it'll be a moving experience to you, because through those doors developed came the wealth of the Carolina Lowcountry because of the work the slaves did in the rice fields.